Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvenni. I am happy to meet you again on the solution and discussion on GATE question paper in the Mechanical Engineering subject. The subject covers are Thermodynamics, Thermal Engineering, Heat and Mass Transfer, Fluid Mechanics and Machines. And this lecture is number 9. The subject what we are going to discuss is Engineering Thermodynamics. The various question papers from Engineering Thermodynamics subject will I give the solution and the discussion wherever required will discuss the solution. And these are all the books I published earlier. Design of Transmission System, Turbo Machines, Heat and Mass Transfer, Operation Research, Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion, Thermal Engineering, Fluid Mechanics and Machinery. Also, I have a YouTube channel where you may find the video lectures on all the subjects, and the solution to the GATE question paper is also uploaded in the YouTube channel. So you please subscribe the YouTube channel so that you will get the lectures and the videos on the GATE question paper solution. And the first question from the 1992 question paper: a condenser of a refrigeration system rejects heat at a rate of 120 kilowatt while its compressor consumes a power of 30 kilowatts. The coefficient of performance of the system would be. So there are four options given: 0.25, 4.33 and 3. And this is the refrigerator. So the heat rejected by the refrigerator to the surrounding is Q1. T1 is the surrounding temperature, higher temperature. T2 is the refrigerator space temperature. The heat extracted from the refrigerator space is Q2, and W is the amount of work input to the refrigerator. So what we are given, Q1 equal to 120 kilowatts. So the heat rejected to the surrounding is 120 kilowatts. The work done is 30 kilowatts. So we have to calculate the COP. So W equal to Q1 minus Q2. So in a cyclic process, net heat transfer equal to net work transfer. So from the first law, so W equal to Q1 minus Q2. So from here, Q2 equal to Q1 minus W, which is 120 minus 30 equal to 90 kilowatts. COP of the refrigerator is refrigeration effect divided by the work done. That is heat rejected from the refrigerator space. That is what refrigeration effect. So Q2 divided by W, 90 by 30 equal to 3. So the answer is 3. Option D, 3. COP equal to 3. The second question from 1993 question paper: a reversible heat transfer demands the temperature difference causing the heat transfer tends to 0. The system receiving heat must be at constant temperature. The system transferring out heat must be at a constant temperature. Both interacting system must at a constant temperature. So for reversible heat transfer, so reversible process, the change of state, so that is infinitesimal. So the adjacent states in the path should be the equilibrium state. So the process should be infinitesimally slow. So for heat transfer process to be reversible, the temperature difference causing the heat transfer should be infinitesimal. So delta T should be infinitesimal. Infinitesimal means very, very small. So very, very small, tending to zero. So when the heat transfer process will be reversible when the temperature difference causing the heat transfer tends to zero, the option is A. The temperature difference causing the heat transfer tends to zero for a heat transfer process to be reversible. The next question from the 1994 question paper: a thermodynamic cycle operating between two temperature limits is reversible if the product of efficiency when operating as a heat engine and the COP when operating as a refrigerator is equal to 1. So what is given? So the heat engine efficiency equal to TH minus TL divided by TH. So TH is the highest temperature of the cycle, TL is the lowest temperature of the cycle. So a COP of the refrigerator, so TL, lowest temperature divided by the temperature difference, TH minus TL. So what is given? The product of efficiency of the heat engine and the COP of the refrigerator. So efficiency of the heat engine in COP of the refrigerator equal to TH minus TL divided by TH into TL by TH minus TL equal to TL by TH. So lower temperature divided by the higher temperature. This ratio is less than 1. So it is given as equal to 1. So but actually the product of efficiency of the heat engine COP of the refrigerator is less than 1. So the statement is false. The statement what is given is false. The next question paper from 1995 question paper. Consider a refrigerator and a heat pump working on the reversed Carnot cycle between same temperature limits. Which of the following statement is correct? COP of the refrigerator equal to COP of the heat pump. COP of the refrigerator equal to COP of the heat pump plus 1. COP of the refrigerator equal to COP of the heat pump minus 1. COP of the refrigerator is equal to inverse of the COP of the heat pump. So we define COP of the refrigerator equal to TL by TH minus TL and COP of the heat pump equal to TH by TH minus TL. So we take the COP of the heat pump TH by TH minus TL. Now in the numerator I subtract TL, add TL. So TH minus TL plus TL, we rearrange TH minus TL divided by TH minus TL plus TL by TH minus TL. So first term is 1 plus the second term is COP of the refrigerator. So COP of the heat pump equal to 1 plus COP of the refrigerator. So rearranging COP of the refrigerator equal to COP of the heat pump minus 1. So the correct statement is third statement C, COP of the refrigerator equal to COP of the heat pump minus 1. Next question from the again from 1995 question paper. In case of a refrigeration system undergoing irreversible cycle, for irreversible cycle, cyclic integral of del Q by T is whether this is less than 0, equal to 0, greater than 0. So from the Clausius inequality, for a reversible cycle, cyclic integral del Q by T less than 0, for a reversible cycle, del Q by T equal to 0, when del Q by T is greater than 0, the cycle is impossible. So here for irreversible cycle, del Q by T is less than 0. And from 2003 question paper, an industrial heat pump operates between the temperatures of 27 degrees Celsius and minus 13 degrees Celsius. The rate of heat addition and heat rejection are 750 watts and 1000 watts respectively. The COP of the heat pump, there are 4 options: 7.5, 6.5, 4.0, 3.0. This is the heat pump. So heat pump rejects the heat energy. Q1 is the amount of heat rejected by the heat pump to the reservoir, which is a temperature, higher temperature T1, and this is the surrounding. So for heat pump, as far as heat pump is concerned, so this is the surrounding at lower temperature. It is supplying heat to a higher temperature reservoir. So T1 equal to 27 degrees Celsius, T2 equal to minus 30 degrees Celsius, and the Q1 equal to 1000. So the amount of rate of heat addition is heat addition to the heat pump is 750, heat rejection is 1000. So Q1 equal to 1000, Q2 equal to 750. So COP equal to desired effect divided by the work input. What is the desired effect? The amount of heat supplied to the reservoir, which is at a higher temperature. So Q1 divided by Q1 minus Q2. So 1000 minus 750 equal to 4. So the answer is 4. The COP of the heat pump equal to 4. Next question from the 2005 question paper. The following 4 figures have been drawn to represent the fictitious thermodynamic cycle on PV and TS plane. Read the diagram. So PV diagram. Figure 1, PV diagram. So the circle is on the clockwise direction. Second diagram, TS diagram. Again the process is in the clockwise direction. Third diagram, PV diagram. The process is in the anti-clockwise direction. Fourth diagram, fourth figure. Again TS diagram. The temperature entropy diagram. The process is in the clockwise direction. According to the first law of thermodynamics, equal area enclosed by figure 1 and 2, figure 1 and 3, figure 1 and 4, figure 2 and 3. Now you compare. figure 1 and 2. So 1, it is in the clockwise direction. 2 is also in the clockwise direction. So this is the PV diagram. This is the TS diagram. So this is the correct answer. This is the correct answer. Why other answers are not correct? So which is correct? 1 and 2, 3 and 4, they are correct. So the combination of 1 and 2, 3 and 4, they are correct. Right? Other options are wrong because 1 is PV diagram in the clockwise direction, 2 TS diagram in the clockwise direction. So your cycle, the work done is given by the PV diagram, heat transfer is given by the TS diagram. And look at PVT and TS, 3 and 4, it is anticlockwise. This is also anticlockwise. These two are combination. So this is one cycle, this is one cycle. The combination of 1 and 2, 3 and 4, they are correct. But 3 and 4 is not given. So it is given 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 2, 3. So you cannot take 1, 3, 1, 4, 2, 3 as an equal diagram. So they are not correct. So the correct answer is 1, 2. So clockwise device is heat engine. Anticlockwise device is heat pump or the refrigerator. So this is for a heat engine and this is for a refrigerator or the heat pump. So the correct answer is figure 1 and 2. And the next question from 2014 question paper. A reversed Carnot cycle refrigerator maintaining a temperature of minus 5 degrees Celsius. The ambient temperature is 35 degrees Celsius. The heat gained by the refrigerator at continuous rate of 2.5 kilojoules per second. The power in watts required to pump out the heat continuously is dash. That is the question. So you have the refrigerator. So R is the refrigerator. Q1 is the heat extracted by the refrigerator. Q2 is the heat extracted by the refrigerator. And Q1 is the heat rejected by the refrigerator. And we are given T1 equal to 35 degrees Celsius, T2 equal to minus 5 degrees Celsius, which is 268 Kelvin. Q2, the heat gained by the refrigerator, Q2 equal to 2.5 kilojoules per second. So we have to calculate power. So COP of the refrigerator, T2 by T1 minus T2 in terms of temperature. So 268 divided by 308 minus 268 equal to 6.7. And the COP of the refrigerator is also equal to heat extracted. So heat extract Q2 divided by W. So W equal to Q2 by COP 2.5 divided by 0.67 equal to 0.373 kilowatts, which is 0.373 kilowatts, which is 373 watts. So the answer is 373 watts. The next question paper from 2015 question paper. The Carnot engine CE1, first Carnot engine, works between two temperature reservoir A and B, where TA equal to 900 Kelvin, TB equal to 500 Kelvin. A second Carnot engine, CE2, second engine, works between reservoir B and C, where TC equal to 300 Kelvin. In each cycle of CE1, CE2, the heat rejected to the reservoir B is used by CE2. For one cycle of operation, if net heat absorbed by CE1 from the reservoir A is 150 megajoules, the net heat rejected to the reservoir 2, reservoir C by CE2 in megajoules is dash. So this is the arrangement. So we have CE1, it is interacting with the TA 900 Kelvin, TB 500 Kelvin. This is CE2, the second is this is CE2, which is interacting with the 500 Kelvin and 300 Kelvin. From the discussion of absolute temperature scale, QA by TA equal to QC by TC. So QA equal to, so from here QC equal to QA by TA into TC. So QA equal to 150 megajoules, TA equal to 900 Kelvin and TC equal to 300 Kelvin. So QC equal to 50 megajoules. That is the answer. So 50 megajoules is the answer. Next question paper from 2015. The COP of a Carnot heat pump operating between 6 degrees Celsius and 37 degrees Celsius is dash. So the Carnot heat pump. So we are given the temperature T1 equal to 37 degrees Celsius, which is 310 Kelvin, and T2 equal to 6 degrees Celsius, which is 379 Kelvin. So COP of the heat pump equal to T1 divided by T1 minus T2, 310 divided by 310 minus 279 equal to 10. So the answer is 10. So the COP of the heat pump equal to 10. And next question from the 2016 question paper, the heat removal rate from a refrigerator space and the power input to the compressor is 7.2 kilowatts and 1.8 kilowatts respectively. The COP of the refrigerator is 4. The answer is 4. So COP of the refrigerator equal to heat, rate of heat removal divided by the work input. So 7.2 divided by 1.8 equal to 4. The answer is 4. And next question, 2017, a heat pump absorbs 10 kilowatt of heat from the outside environment at 250 Kelvin while absorbing 15 kilowatt of work. It delivers the heat to a room that must be kept warm at 300 Kelvin. The COP of the heat pump, the answer is 1.67. So what is given here? We are given QT equal to 10 kilowatt, W equal to 15 kilowatt. So Q1, so for the heat pump, so this is the heat pump. So Q1 equal to Q2 plus W, so 25. So COP of the heat pump equal to Q1 by W, 25 by 15 equal to 1.67. That is the answer. Next question from 2019 question paper. A heat pump is to supply heat at a rate of 10 kilowatt to a building to be maintained at 22 degrees Celsius. The outside temperature is 2 degrees Celsius. The minimum power in kilowatt required to run the heat pump is dash round to 2 decimal point. So this is your heat pump. We are given T1 equal to 22 degrees Celsius, T2 equal to 2 degrees Celsius, which is 275 Kelvin. Q1, the heat pump is to supply heat at rate of 10 kilowatt. So Q1 equal to 10 kilowatt. COP of the heat pump equal to T1 divided by T1 minus T2, which is 295 divided by 295 minus 275 equal to 14.75. So W equal to Q1 by COP of the heat pump. So 10 divided by 14.75 equal to 0.68 kilowatts. So the answer is 0.68 kilowatts. Next from the question paper 1993. Round the clock cooling of an apartment having a load of 300 megajoules per day requires an air conditioning plant of capacity about 110, 510, 1010 and 110. There are 4 options. We have to select the correct answer. So capacity is 300 megajoules per day. So 300 megajoules. So 300 into 1000. It becomes kilojoules. 300 kilojoules per day. So 24 hours, 60 into 60. So that is converted. Time is converted into seconds. So 300 into 1000 divided by 24 into 60 into 60 equal to 3.47 kilojoules per second. We know 1 ton of refrigeration equal to 3.5 kilojoules per second. So the Q equal to 3.47 divided by 3.5 equal to 0.9910, which is 1 ton. So the capacity of the refrigeration plant required is 1 ton capacity. And this is from the 1996 question paper. A solar energy based heat engine which receives 80 kilojoules of heat at 100 degrees Celsius and rejects 70 kilojoules of heat to ambient at 330 degrees Celsius is to be designed. The thermal efficiency of the heat engine is 70%, 1.88%, 12.5% indeterminate. So the efficiency of the heat engine equal to 1 minus Q2 by Q1, which is 1 minus 70 by 80 equal to 0.125, which is 12.5%. So the answer is 12.5%. Again from 1996 question paper, for 2 cycles coupled in series, the topping cycle has an efficiency of 30% and the bottoming cycle has an efficiency of 20%. The overall combined cycle efficiency is 50%, 44%, 38% and 55%. So eta 1 is the efficiency of the topping cycle, which is 30%. Eta 2 is the efficiency of the bottoming cycle, which is 20%. Eta equal to the efficiency of the combined cycle, eta 1 plus eta 2 minus eta 1 eta 2, which is 0.3 plus 0.2 minus 0.3 into 0.2 equal to 0.44. So 44%. So the answer is 44%. So next question from 2001 question paper. A cyclic heat engine does 50 kilojoules of work per cycle. If the efficiency of the heat engine is 75%, then the heat rejected per cycle is 16.67 kilojoules, 33.33 kilojoules, 37.5 kilojoules, 66.67 kilojoules. So Q1 is the heat supplied, so Q2 is the heat rejected, W is the work done, which is 50 kilojoules. So we have to calculate for the heat engine, Q1 heat supplied equal to W by efficiency. So 50 divided by 0.75 equal to 66.67. The heat rejected Q2 equal to Q1 minus W. So 66.67 minus 50 equal to 16.67 kilojoules. So the answer is 16.67 kilojoules. So we stop here. So thank you for watching. You please post your comments in the YouTube video, take a YouTube video comments box. So I will use the comment for improving the video. You subscribe the YouTube channel so that you will get the updated video on the GATE coaching and other subjects what I have published in the YouTube channel. So you can contact me through my email ID or WhatsApp number for any queries. I will sincerely answer to your queries. So thank you very much for watching once again. We'll meet again.